Hey everybody, and welcome back to Exercise of the Day with Genesis Health Clubs. I'm Ben Heithoff, and this is Andy Held. We're some of your GenesisGo virtual personal training coaches. We're going to go over push-up and push-up modifications today and the proper technique in them. More complex than you think, kind of surprisingly so. So again, a very, very common exercise that people are doing at home, and people are looking for a variety of ways to do this without getting bored. I think we had you covered on that today. So starting off, there's a couple of primary muscle groups that you know you're going to be using. We want to make sure you're aware of. One is your pectorals. Now, with your pectorals, Andy's going to show you. You have all these different angles that we can work your pectoral fibers. Okay. So a common one is your close grip. Next one is we'll kind of consider a 45 degree, and then the last one is going to be in kind of a T position. Very, very good there. Now, when we go through these push-up things, just so you know, wider push-up hand positions doesn't make it more effective. It really doesn't, okay? So just keep that in mind, okay? So Andy's going to demonstrate. We're going to go over some of the main things we see go wrong in the push-up, and I'm going to start with actually spinal position. So my checklist before I have a client do a push-up is we want to have core is engaged, lats are really tight, glutes are actually on, so these hips sink a little lower just a tad there, that looks really good. And then we want shoulders down and back. We don't want those suckers up by the ears like you're doing a shrug. Do a shrug so they can see. No, we don't want that. Really good. Yeah, we want them down and back. Now, I'm going to have Andy do a 45-degree angle with his elbows as he goes into a push-up. Notice his whole body moves together. And then back up. He can hold that all day. That was great. Now, some other things you'll notice. Hand positions. We don't want to externally rotate them out. We want to keep those straight forward. And same with the thumbs. They're aligned, pointing straight forward. Again, this puts the shoulders in a great position, along with getting your pectoral fibers to kick in. Awesome. Now let's say Andy's like, hey, I need to work on my triceps a little bit more. We're going to go to a close grip one. You'll hit the shoulders a little bit more with this. Some common mistakes that we see with people is they let the shoulder girdle rotate forward. So you see how we did that there? And then they don't let the shoulder blades move together. These are meant to move. Let them move, okay? So as he goes down, those come together, shoulders stay back, comes up, has a full contraction on the top end, okay? Now we're going to go to basically a T position there. So his elbow joint is going to be kind of even with the shoulder girdle, just a little below. We don't want to create a weird angle as far as where his forearm is concerned, where his shoulder and wrists are lining up. So he's going to go do his 90-degree angle push-up. Notice the alignment right across the back, nice and even, a little bit below the shoulder. What we don't want to do is do that and have the elbows flare up towards the ears. That creates a lot of rotation and stresses that rotator cuff group in the shoulder girdle. Okay? Really good.
How you feeling? That's working.
I like it. Now, if you have any other exercises you would like for us to do, comment below. If you're in need of more coaching or need a more progressive exercise plan, get a free consultation. Click on that link below and one of our coaches will give it to you as soon as we can. Thanks, guys.